All right, so now I'm going to be battling with Rug Aggro Control Combo, whatever you want to call it. It's a rug deck. The specialty about this deck is it plays out different, like, every game. It's got some of the most powerful spells. The problems with it is sometimes you just don't have much action. Your oracles are missing, you're not hitting line drops with Cobra, you're preordaining into explorers and explorers into preordains, and it just keeps going. But there's a lot of upsides to the deck. It's originally was a Michael Jacob creation back in block, and we've been working on it. A couple of things about this list I like I like the mana leaks. He told me to play for C. The sideboard is a creation of Michael Jacobs, except a couple cards that I like to play in it. I've never really sideboarded with this deck, with the new sideboard. It's a lot different than the one that me and my brother played at States, so it'll take a little getting used to, but the coolest thing I have is Summoning Trap for the blue control matchups. They're going to try countering your Lotuses and your Oracles really early, and you can just slam down something like Sitting Slime's like the worst threat, but it's still pretty good. Like, turn two, just blow up their land. Guy's Revenge is obviously just amazing against the control decks, and then even an early Frost Titan or Infernal Titan can just finish a game up. So we're going to play that, and I will challenge Luis again. And he wins the die roll again. I never really win any die rolls. It's starting to get annoying. So, like, this hand on the play is just phenomenal. And he's blue-black again. We did just drop Preordain. I was going to Depths first, but Preordain is just a much more powerful spell. Depths is like the old Preordains. Having a Lightning Bolt this early is probably a good thing. Just in case he has a Jace, which he probably does. But the Frost Titan's a little too early, so we're going to bottom the Frost Titan and keep the Lightning Bolt. It's not the greatest card in the matchup, and it could just end up becoming a dead card, but it's going to protect our Jace from a Creeping Tar Pit, and it's going to kill his Jace. So we want a way to attack his Jace, or protect ours. So this turn we're just going to play our Gorge and Explore. He might have a counter spell for it. He might choose to counter it. Keeping the stick off its mana is really good. That is definitely manageable. And now, like, we could play a Copperland Gorge so it doesn't come into play tap later, but we won't have double blue for a Jace. And since he's on the play and he hasn't really done anything, we're going to want to get a Jace in play. So, wow, that's a good top three. We want all of them. Island is... No, we do want the Island before the third card, because... Next turn we're going to play Forest, and we're going to try to play Jace. And then the turn after that we're going to play Island and try to play Jace with Lightning Bolt back up. So we're just going to go Jace, Island for C. And then the other thing that could potentially happen is if he... Alright, he didn't go Jace tick up. So with him only having four cards and us having three Jaces, I feel pretty good right now. So what we're going to do is we're just going to play the Forest and start getting some counter spells out of his hand. Want to protect the Oracle, because the Oracle is actually going to be pretty good. If it was vice versa, we would play an Oracle if we didn't have as many Jaces. So like right here, this works out perfect. We're gonna be able to play an island and bounce his Persecutor, and we have a Lightning Bolt to protect it from him attacking it. What does he have? Frost Titan? Okay. I do not mind having to just bounce the Frost Titan and get an extra land and an extra card out of the deal. So yeah, but what's going to happen is now I don't have red open, then he's going to be able to attack the Jace. But we have a backup. Might be able to get two of them online next turn. So he has Abyssal Persecutor and Frost Titan in hand, and if he draws another land, he's able to double activate. It's kind of getting ugly. So we're just going to say go here. If he does get the land double activate, he kills it the next turn. We're still able to go Oracle into 4C and get an abundance of lands. Or if we hit an extra couple lands, we can just double Oracle. We're still going to bolt off one of the tar pits. Gives him less mana next turn. And we get a land off the top and another land off the top. We have no control over we're gonna miss these cards no matter what, so kind of sucks, but we can't control it. And yeah, I think I'm just gonna. No, I think foresee we need to get some action here, and all of these are pretty bad. And we pretty much just whiffed. It's pretty frustrating. But Explore's not terrible here, because what we're going to do is, during our turn, we're gonna crack the Misty and try to get a spell off the top of our library. I don't like him playing Frost Titan here. I mean, the Effigy is going to hurt us no matter what. And I took the Avengers out for the, didn't think they were going to be that great. Well, I want that. And I want that. So we can actually get both oracles and crack a bunch of lands, but I don't like doing that. Since we only have one more forest, we have one more basic of each basic left. Oh, no, we have the mountain here, so. Now he's going to be able to go Frost Titan and play a guy, so we have to get the Jason to play and just bounce it and... There's no real choice here. We've used every single Mind Sculptor, and we're still way behind. Ugh. Alright, well. That is not good. We got a Titan. Two. Well, we can take out the Titan with our Titan. And we have a counterspell, but it's not going to do anything. I guess I can protect this 20 persecutors. We don't even have deprived mana unless we draw land. Because, oh, the forest, I guess, yeah, never mind. It costs 8. No, yeah, we need a land to be able to do anything. No. No. This blue black deck looks really good. Persecutor now too? Jeez. We're falling way behind. I don't even know if I want this deprive anymore. I do not. That is a dead top deck though. Yeah, if we Titan his Jace, he just taps the guy down. And with knowing that that's Cobra and he has Jace, like, we're never gonna get a fresh draw, we're never gonna be able to kill the Jace, so this game is over. So, for sideboarding, Flameslash is obviously just very bad against him. We're going to bring in our Jace and the Summoning Traps and an Acidic Slime and Revenge. We need to cut 4 cards. I don't want to cut all the bolts, but I don't think we have an option here. I think just Bolt has to come out, and we have to hope to take the aggressive. On the draw, we might bring him back in, but on the play, we just don't have room for him.